Grub Parson of Newcastle is no more, but it's still known and respected the world over by the astronomers who still use the lenses and telescopes produced at the Heaton factory. One of the firm's leading lens makers bought his old firm's equipment and has set up a factory at Wrighton. His latest project has been to bring one of the original Grub telescopes back to its spiritual home. Alan Powell now reports.
After looking across millions of miles of space for the best part of a century, a classic telescope has come 400 miles from Devon to Tyneside for overhaul. Not that much needed doing apart from a thorough cleaning, for this is the product of one of the master builders of Victorian telescopes, Sir Howard Grubb. Both a telescope and a camera, it dates from the heyday of astronomy when photography was beginning to make an important contribution to the visual exploration of the heavens. The most important job is to give the instrument new lenses. These are being polished on one of the very machines designed and used by Grubb himself in the 1870s. Grubb made Newcastle a world centre for telescopes, a tradition that would have died but for one man.
For many years I worked for the old Grubb firm. Grubb was a master engineer. He was one of the great old English engineers. He was a Rembrandt of the lens-making age. He was a miraculous and skillful man, a craftsman in the very best traditions. And for many years I was fortunate to work in his works. And that sort of skill and that sort of capability fills my whole world. The process of turning a raw piece of glass into something which is incredibly accurate and very beautiful. It's a highly skillful and very, very satisfying process. Money doesn't come into it. If you think of a massive block of optical glass, it contains within it all of the capabilities of making a very, very fine lens. It's in there. All we've got to do is cut away the outside, grind away the outside, and find that super accurate surface inside. And the process is exactly like sculpture. You literally cut away the material you want to get rid of, and what you're left with is the thing that you want. And this can be made extremely accurate. In optics, we can achieve tremendous accuracies. We can go down to, without any difficulty, a thousandth of the thickness of a human hair, literally 2 or 3 millionths of an inch. And most of our standard products here are considerably better than that.
It's almost a paradox that to look across the immense distances of space, one needs to work to the smallest scale imaginable. To test his lenses and mirrors, David Sinden uses tiny wavelengths of light to reveal the smallest imperfections, a method so sensitive that it can detect the difference in air temperature caused by the heat of a human hand, measurable perhaps in only thousandths of a degree. In a few weeks, the precious lenses will be ready for the completed telescope, by then back in its observatory in Sidmouth, proving that despite space probes and radio astronomy, this giant from the past still has a future.
In order to get that right. That instrument can reveal miracles and wonders in the sky, marvellous things in the sky. When we get it finished and we put our lenses in it, that will be a marvellous instrument to look through.